please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
she conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be done to me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
Dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promise of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, made by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Mary, help of Christians.
Pray for.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning. Welcome to the shrine of St. John Bosco the Dreamer. Together with our personal intentions, we also include the following. For the gift of life and birth, the intentions of Daryl Hazareno, Russ Laurent, Jones Nabos, Rodney, Matthew Babasoro, Joshua Austria, James Ramos, and of B.J. Parnio. Thanksgiving on the occasion on the 25th wedding anniversary of Robert and Marilo Paraiso. Misa pasalamat sa Santissima Trinidad, Mother of God, ug San Jose. Sa mga kalag sa Purgatorio, ilabi na sa kalag ni Pablo ug Father George, offered by Sotera. For the healing, recovery, and good health of Riza de los Reyes, Manolo Miguel, Bebe Pertimos, and of Aloisa Lior. For the intentions of CJ and Macy Carandang, Joseph, Eldin, Clinton, Brian, Frenchie, Princess Grace, Rio, Jessa, Isaine, Robert and Marilu, Angela Fatima Lois, and of Renee, Monique, and Rudy. For the eternal repose of the souls of Eileen R. O'Malley, Alberto, Crescente Tabanao, Father George Militante SDB, Mercedes Secretaria, Madre Ana Maria Aguera, Madre Julia Soto, Madre Ana Maria Diaz. For the death anniversary of Rebecca Soto, and for the souls of Nicasio Soto, Francisca Soto, Eduardo Soto, Columba Baguio, Evangeline Fidiliaga, Alfredo Fidiliaga Jr., offered by Fidiliaga family, and for the eternal repose of the souls in purgatory, especially those who died in war, from natural calamities and of COVID-19. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we are gathered together as a community to praise and thank the Lord for the many graces and blessings that He continues to pour upon us. In this Holy Mass, we pray for our personal and community intentions. We are also joined today by Father Rooney Undar, SDB, who in this Holy Mass. We pray as well for his intentions. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who called the Bishop Saint Irenaeus to confirm true doctrine and the peace of the Church, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that being renewed in faith and charity, we may always be intent on fostering unity and concord. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this word, O children of Israel, that the Lord pronounces over you, over the whole family that I brought up from the land of Egypt. You alone have I favored, more than all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your crimes. Do two walk together unless they have agreed? Does a lion roar in the forest when it has no prey? Does a young lion cry out for its den unless it has seized something? Is a bird brought to earth by a snare where there is no lure for it? Does a snare spring up from the ground without catching anything? If the trumpet sounds in a city, will the people not be frightened? If evil befalls a city, has not the Lord caused it? Indeed, the Lord God does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. The lion roars, who will not be afraid? The Lord God speaks, who will not prophesy? I brought upon you such upheaval as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah. You were like a brand plucked from the fire, yet you returned not to me, says the Lord. So now I will deal with you in my own way, O Israel. And since I will deal thus with you, prepare to meet your God, O Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
At dawn, I bring my plea expectantly before you. For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
You hate all evildoers. You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful man, the Lord abhors.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
But I, because of your abundant mercy, will enter your house. I will worship at your holy temple in fear of you, O Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Please stand.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus got into a boat, his disciples followed him. Suddenly, a violent storm came up on the sea, so that the boat was being swamped by waves, but he was asleep. They came and woke him, saying, "Lord, save us, we are perishing." He said to them, "Why are you terrified, O you of little faith?" Then he got up, rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. The men were amazed and said, "What sort of man is this, whom even the winds and the sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise your Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. When we talk about an earthquake in the sea, we think of its effect, which is a tsunami. A tsunami is a series of large waves caused by movements in Earth's crust, or by earthquakes, or by undersea volcanic eruptions. We heard news about its devastating effects that led to death and displacement of many peoples. But why are we talking about earthquake in the sea and tsunamis? In today's gospel, according to Matthew, Jesus and his disciples experienced a sudden violent storm on the sea, which rocked their boat. The evangelist used the Greek term seismos, meaning earthquake, to describe the violent storm that Jesus and his disciples met in the middle of the sea. And probably they were experiencing a kind of tsunami then, or large waves. Many biblical scholars interpret this symbolic language as a turning point of the ages. The foundations of the old world are shaken by the coming of God's kingdom, and that Jesus' life, ministry, and preaching challenges each one of us to the point of being shaken from our usual way of living. The Word of God continues to call us to conversion and repentance, even to the point of making a paradigm shift or a change in one's life direction. And in the opening line of the gospel, the disciples followed Jesus as he got into the boat, not completely knowing what will happen along the way. But as Christians, we also follow the Lord, and he will also rock us or shake us in order to purify and liberate us from many enslaving factors and realities in the world today. Let us not be afraid, for our Lord Jesus is with us in the boat, and he will be there all throughout our journey. Today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Irenaeus, a bishop, martyr, and a father of the church. He was born about the year 125 and was influenced by Saint Polycarp, who had known the apostles and their immediate disciples. Irenaeus is called a father of the church, for he is one of those who laid the foundations of Christian theology. And when the church was rocked by heresies, Irenaeus was there to refute the errors of Gnosticism present at the time. He lived as a good shepherd to his flock, leading them to the truth about our Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this Eucharist today, we are all invited to listen to the Word of God. And as we listen to God's Word, we allow it to speak to us, to inspire us, and to shake us, in order to deepen our following the Lord.
as His disciples. And when we are challenged, let us be open to redirect our lives back to Him, to change our sinful ways, and to live good and holy lives until the end. Amen.
Even the wind and the sea obey the Son of God. With this in mind, we can pray confidently for calm in a turbulent world. Lord, grant us your peace.
Lord, grant us your peace. That the Church, through its members, may be strong in faith, especially in facing the difficulties and challenges of our time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That sea travelers, sailors, fishermen, and those who earn their living from the sea may feel safe and secure. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That those who doubt their faith may be strengthened through the help and support of their friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That the disabled and those suffering from lingering illnesses may find inner peace in Christ's healing power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
That the dead may experience the everlasting peace of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your peace.
Prayer for protection against COVID-19. Dear God, our loving Father,
we ask you to extend your hand over us to protect us, especially from the harm, from the threat that is brought about by COVID-19. We ask you also to continually guide and enlighten those who take care of our health, the government, our doctors, our nurses, those who are working, especially in the hospitals and all the frontliners, so that they may continue their work in order to safeguard the health of the community. This we ask of you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Heavenly Father, may the trials and troubles of life's storm-tossed waters purify us and bring lasting peace to our souls. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice we offer you with joy on the heavenly birthday of Saint Irenaeus bring you glory, O Lord, and instill in us a love of the truth, so that we may keep the church's faith inviolate and her unity secure. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we with all the host of angels cry out, and without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Irenaeus, Saint John Bosco, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen. Spiritual communion. O Jesus, I turn toward the Holy Tabernacle, where you live hidden for love of me. I love you, my God. I cannot receive you in Holy Communion. Come nevertheless and receive me with your grace, Come spiritually into my heart, purify it, sanctify it, render it like unto your own. Amen.
Let us pray. Through these sacred mysteries, we pray, O Lord, give us in your compassion an increase of that faith which brought glory to the Bishop Saint Irenaeus as he maintained it even until death. And may the same faith bring to us who truly follow it justification in your sight. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks.